What's up, folks? Welcome again on another episode of Florida Hopping, and today we're sitting here at Orlando International Airport at MCO. We are the little plane over there you can see from above. We're on a terminal at your gate 36, and it should be airside 1. But yep, as you can see, we're just we should be able to do a pushback. No, yeah, we'll do maybe a quick turn. We don't need to do a pushback. We should be able to. But yeah, let's hop in and see. So we got the power already fired up. We're just waiting for to continue with the rest of the briefing, so we don't need to do that. What we're gonna do is basically check the flight plan and everything. So gonna turn on this guy. All right, just waiting for the Garmin to start up, and then we should be fine. Okay, perfect. We're good. Alright, so let's see if we can actually get the company route work this time. Procedure menu. Flight plan. Okay, we're gonna delete all this. Delete flight plan. Okay, and save flight, activate. Well, no, I guess we'll just do it. Just do that. Clear. Alright, so we are MCO. What we're gonna do is go next. Waypoint is Vista. And I'm gonna type that in. Okay. Victor, India. And Zulu should be Zulu, yeah. Okay, Vits Tango Alpha, Vista. Alright, yes, US Southeast, that's the one. Then Cross City, so it's Charlie Tango Yankee. So today's flight is going to be under Silver Wings 161, that's our call sign, and we're going to be flying at a flight level of 180. It's going to be a pretty long flight for the turboprops. It's the longest flight for Silver Airways. It's going to be from Orlando to Huntsville, Alabama. We should be able to have a good weather all the way through. We might be a bit gusty approach in Huntsville, but overall should be fine. Cross City, that one inserted, and then Sierra Zulu Victor. I always forget the name, but it's a pretty famous, well-known VOR in Florida. Sierra Zulu and Whiskey, not Victor. Whiskey. Seminole, yeah. No, anyway. Okay, Seminole's was ready over there. And then VUZ, so that's Victor Uniform Zulu. Victor Uniform. I missed the U, okay. Right, and Zulu, go all the way down. Vulcan, okay, and then the last waypoint is gonna be DCU, so that's Delta Charlie Alpha, so it's Delta. And then we have Charlie here. Oh, no, wrong. Charlie and Alpha Oxon. Is that the one we're looking for? Okay, VOR. So what I'm gonna do is basically see if everything looks normal. Wrong. Okay, so the DCA is wrong. DCU uniform. That is why. Flight plan. DCU, it's gonna be. Nope. Oh, clear. Clear. Okay, so we're gonna do this one and the Charlie again, and this time is uniform. I got it wrong before. Okay, southeast. Alright, and we need to delete this boy. Remove waypoint, yes, and then we put the waypoint, we put Huntsville here. Okay. Hotel Sierra Victor. Oops. Oops. Victor. Huntsville International. Upset, yes. Okay, so the flight plan is, I'm gonna check it again. Goes up, we should be able to have our, okay, so that's good. Yeah, that's what we kind of want. Yes, that's what we want, exactly. Okay, so we're good in there. So we've had the FMC, you have a GPS, everything set up, the route is set. We're gonna continue with the before engine start. What we're gonna do is actually ask for ATC, if still available, I think. I'm gonna check. Connect. Yeah, that's good enough, and it's silver 161. Silver 161. Connect. And we wanna check if the radar's still on. To show who's online. It's not showing up who's online. Oh yes. Okay, so we have Jacksonville on, so I'm gonna Miami Center. KMCOA, it is 121250. Okay. 121. And we're gonna.
Available. Landing runways 18 right, 17 right, and 17 left. Departing runways 18 right and 17 right. Notices to airmen. Airport surface detection equipment in use. Squawk altitude reporting mode fee on all taxiways and runways. Bridge and deer activity in vicinity of airport. Taxiway Juliet 3 and Juliet 4 restricted to wingspans less than 118 feet. Include your call sign in all readbacks. Upon receipt of your ATC clearance, read back only your squawk code. Advised on initial contact, you have information.
Information what?
Orlando Airport 8 is information Bravo.
Bravo.
215-3 Zulu. Wind 116 at 12. Visibility 10. Few clouds at 5,000. Temperature 25. Duke 16. Altimeter 3012. Simultaneous visual approach is runways 17 left and 17 right in use.
Okay.
Visual approach runway 18 right. ILS approach available on request. Landing runways 18 right, 17 right, and 17 left. Departing runways 18 right and 17 right. Notices to airmen. Airport surface detection equipment in use.
So 18 right.
Squawk altitude recording mode fee on all taxiways
right.
And runways.
If you're gonna give me something.
Bridge and deer activity in vicinity of airport.
So that's good.
Taxiway Juliet 3 and Juliet 4 restricted to wingspans less than 118 feet. Include your call sign in all readbacks. Upon receipt of your AT.
Keep Jacksonville South. I think that's 134850. 134 85. Okay, so we're gonna get the clearance from Miami Center, and we
can... American 220, are you able to, the skids to departure? Well, actually, you know what, it's not really necessary, I can work around. American 220, cleared to the Tango Kilo Papa Kilo Airport via radar vectors to skips that has filed. I'm maintain 5,000. Expect flight level 310. 31 as a final. 1 German attempt departure. And squawk 4561. Southwest 488 descend and maintain 2,000. Southwest 488, descend and maintain 2,000.
One more Southwest 488.
Southwest 488, descend and maintain 2,000.
2,048.
United 446, climb and maintain flight level 370.
Oh, the 370, yeah, it's 446.
Miami South.
American 220. Sorry, American 220. It's direct to skips. Sierra Kilo India Papa Sierra as you filed and that has filed. You can expect flight level 310 as a final and squawk 4561.
Can we make sure that 11 is ready to go once to the left at Palm Beach?
Miami Center, good evening.
Zulu Echo 18, Zulu Echo 18110070 at 9R, runway 10 left, clear for takeoff.
Good takeoff. Certificate 11.
Just forgot that I'm streaming.
There, on 318 is ready for the departure.
Alright. Pardon my French.
Orange 318, sorry about that. Wind is 050 at 10. Runway 8 right, clear for takeoff. And that are not goes out. I'm sure you don't have a garment, so just sliding 090, runway 8 right, clear for takeoff. Orange 318.
Sure, heading 090, right, clear takeoff on 380.
American 112 heavy, runway 8 right, line up and wait.
He's super busy.
8 right, line up and wait, American 112.
Good evening, Miami. This is Silver Wings 161 at gate 36 at MCO. We'd like to pick up our IFR clearance. We have information, Bravo.
At Orlando, you can monitor Unicom, or I'm sorry, contact Jacksonville on 134.85.
Alrighty, sorry for that.
No problem.
Miami Center, JetBlue 511 is at...
Good evening, Jackson. This is Silver Wings 161. With you at gate 36, Orlando MCO, in Information Bravo, we'd like to pick up our IFR clearance to Huntsville. Let's see if this guy picks up.
Silverwing is 161 Jack Center, cleared to the Huntsville Airport, Orlando for departure, then it's filed. Maintain 5,000, expect flight level 18010 minutes after departure, frequency 134.85, squawk 1670.
We're clear, okay, Rogers, Silver Wings 161, we're clear for Huntsville via Orlando for departure, and then as filed, initial climb 5,000 feet, expect flight level 180 in 10 minutes, and 13485 departure frequency with you, squawk 1670 for Silver Wings 161. got it, bitch. Was I pressing the wrong number?
Texas, Baron 81, Alpha Bravo, Hotel Runway 8.
Baron 815, Alpha Bravo, Jacksonville winds 110 at 10, runway cleared for takeoff.
Baron 815, I understand. Clear for takeoff.
Jackson, Silver Wings 161, I don't know if you've got my read back, just waiting.
Silver Wings 161, negative nothing, that came through for you for the read back.
Alright, I probably pressed the wrong button, but so we're clear for Huntsville International via the Orlando 4 departure, then as filed, 5,000 feet initial climb, expect 180 in 10 minutes. Departure frequency 13485 and squawk 1670 for Silver Wings at 161.
Silver Wings 161, read back. Mission started at your discretion. Expect runway 18 left for departure. Call for taxi, Orlando information, Bravo Scarlet.
Roger, we'll push back and start as discretion, and we expect 18 left. And we have Bravo, Silver Wings 161. So 18 left. Okay. Load. Alright, perfect flight plan. Such a mess. Okay, so we have been clear for push and start. What we're gonna do, it's actually the push and start, so we have, we're gonna check, and we're gonna do before engine start, batteries checked on, external power checked on, bleed valves reset and off. Reset and off.
And Baron 8, went up for Bravo, just turn your squawk 1211, currently showing you squawking.
Circuit breakers checked, flight recorder, so we're gonna put 161.
Can you repeat that? I couldn't hear you.
Baron 815 Alpha Bravo, just confirm this walking 1211.
Okay, flight recorder set, parking brake set, cabin sign is on, engine instrument and ignition check.
Baron 815 Bravo, squawk 1211.
Yes. Hydraulics checked, and while we're here, we're gonna do this thing too. Okay. Hydraulics checked in green.
Baron 815 Alpha Bravo.
Our condition.
Radar contact high altitude.
Perfect. Trims. We are good on trims. Takeoff data bugs. So. Thing was 105. It's the rotation. Okay. What's that? Climb.
Baron 815 Alpha Bravo. High altitude.
Beacon doors closed, it checked.
Baron 815 Alpha Bravo.
Okay. So we are not going to, we're gonna taxi to the no movement area. Where is that? Okay, so
Baron 815 Alpha Bravo, you might have cut out there, just stay altitude leaving.
So we're gonna start the.
Baron 815, let's stop. I'm having trouble really hearing you. Roger, Baron 815, Bravo. Okay, squeezing out to...
Baron 815 Alpha Bravo, a right turn on course approved, and would you like flight following?
Alright, so checking, this is on ground idle.
Delta 1684 Jack Center. Radar contact 20 miles north of the Tip Myers VOR flight level 330. Welcome aboard.
Okay, we're having a whistle. Start position. And then back to ignition. Okay, so engine started. We're good in there. We're pausing start on that engine. What we're gonna do is alright, and generator's on. Looks fine here, and looks screwed. Actually, this is not on yet.
Baron 815 up, begin the Jack's low class drop phase frequency change approved.
Okay, so we're good.
Baron 815 up, frequency change approved. Have a good day.
Let me see if the sounds like kind of weird, why I can't hear much. That's good. Okay, and are we going to the new DXL power? Looks good. And we can call the truck and everything out. Just remove everything. GPU off. And now we can start with the second engine. Right, engine start. Spooling up. Okay, once it's settled, everything is set. Okay. Gen on.
5,000 feet
it's set in here.
Right, 10 Charlie Tango, Jack Center, turn right heading 090, descend and maintain 8,000 vectors for descent. November 810 Charlie Tango, turn right heading 090, descend and maintain 8,000. You can expect the visual approach, runway 17 left, Orlando, altimeter 3012, vectors for descent.
Okay,
0090,
heading in.
Delta 1684, are you able to accept crossing restrictions at a waypoint? Jack Center, reach 6075, we're pick up for clearance to Toronto, about Orlando. Reach 1675, Jack Center. Are you able to accept the McCoy 2 uniform? Affirmative, route
6075.
You can expect the visual approach on a 17 left.
Oh,
route 1675, cleared to the Toronto Airport. McCoy to departure then is filed. Maintain 5,000. Expect flight 70, 10 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 134.85. Squawk is 1700. Clear to the Toronto, McCoy 2 departure, initial 5,000, and we got squawk 1700 for route 1675. Route 1675, read back, correct. Push and start at your discretion, expect runway 17 right for departure in a call taxi. Information, Bravo's current. Route 1675. Delta 1684, cross Piglet, have maintained 11,000 at 250 knots. The Orlando altimeter 3012. Number 810 Charlie Tango, turn right heading 180.
Jackson, Silver Wings 161, push and start is completed, we are ready to taxi.
Silver Wings 161, runway 18 left, taxi via Echo, Charlie, Bravo 1.
Runway 18 left, Echo, Charlie, Bravo 1, Silver Wings 161.
Number number 810 Charlie Tango, turn right heading 270.
American 419 to Maya Space Atlanta Center is closed. Frequency change repair.
Runway 10 Charlie Tango flying 360 to sun maintain 3000. Hill there, 161, turn your transponders.
Alright, I'll check that now.
Okay.
set this to south. 5818.
Zero Charlie Tango, are you going to the West PA route?
Coming home to
Atlanta, yes, people. Okay, 10 Charlie Tango, so this approach runway 18 right.
This is
18 right
from Bill, Chris Tango, Bill Tango.
Delta 161, winds 1012, right 18 left with the takeoff flight 270.
Roger, we're cover takeoff runway 18 left, and please can you give again the heading to follow for Silver Wings 161?
270.
Roger, heading 270 after departure, Silver Wings 161.
Alright,
we're good for takeoff and we are
checking the inside. 810 Charlie, do you not to make 18 right now? 17 right. 17 right, that way.
Shine 7 0 7 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0
Silver 161, we're landing to Hunter in our contacts, the altitude landing.
Passing 1,700 right now, Silver Wings at 161.
161, roger, fly heading 300, climb maintain 16,000.
300 and climb maintain what, 6,000, Silver Wings at 161.
Route 1675 approaching Hotel 3, taxi 17 right, information help.
1675, runway 17 right, taxi left hotel, hotel 1.
17 right, left hotel, hotel 1, route 1675. Jacksonville, the east side, looks like there's people there.
Okay, we'll
do the options. Check. 1017, Jacksonville Center, clear to the Fort Lauderdale Airport via X-Box 2 departure. Ormond Beach transition, then a style, maintain 8,000, expect level 2301, 0 minutes after departure. Departure. 134.85, squawk 1001.
The 2 full letters I'll be back. After Ormond Beach transition, then a style, climb 8,000, expect level 2301, 0 minutes after departure. Departure is going to be up with you on 134.85, and we're squawking 1001, Jeff Lieutenant.
1017, is that correct? Runway 8 for departure, Jacksonville, altimeter 3012, call for that mistake.
Runway 8 for departure, we'll park back into the different
seat.
Route 1675,
ready to go for runway 17 right.
Route 1675, winds 110.12, runway 17 right, clear for takeoff, fly heading 60.
160, the heading clear for takeoff, runway 17 right, 1675.
Delta 1368, contact approach 120.65.
So that is done. Seat KMCO, so we are not following any kind of seat, so we just fly over there. We should be good.
Route 1675 airborne 1,671.60.
Route 1675, we're landing departure center contact, line maintain 16,000, clear direct 1.
Clear direct climb and maintain 1,000.
Route 675.
Delta 1684, depart Tegu-Tacoma, pressure direct across Hammy at or above 3,000, cleared ILS runway 18 right approach.
Jacksonville
Center,
good evening. This is
United
446 with
Defable
370, currently
275 nautical miles on ILM. Center, TBM November 320 Tango Bravo, request flight level 280.
I'm into 280. I'm into 280.
Common 18 flight level 280, 0-10 Bravo, thank you. Jacksonville Center, good evening, Blue 511 is with you, flight level 340.
Okay, so let's check. We're closing here, we're good.
511 Jacksonville Center, good evening.
Check. So we're getting close to Vitsa. We are over actually in Pinau, so yes.
Okay, this is 3, this is 5, 4, 3, 11, 8, 9.
What is it?
American 209, Jacksonville Center, clear to fly request standby. Over 161, climb maintain flight level 180, clear direct to dispatch.
Climb the final flight level 180 and clear direct to VITSA, Silver Wings 161. Okay, so we've got good, we've got our clearance. Do we want to
go over here? Route 1675, request pass.
1675, climb maintain flight level 370. Jacksonville Center, Jeffrey 1017.
Okay, so we've got our direct bits and that's going to be a continuous climb. We're going to continue climbing to our flight level 180 and we should be good to go now.
JetBlue, 1017, Jack, sorry.
And JetBlue 1017, very fast. We had you here.
JetBlue 1017, Jack Delta, clear runway 8, taxi to Juliet Alpha Lima, and eject to altimeter 3011.
Juliet Alpha Lima, 3011, JetBlue 1017.
Okay, so after we're done, we're going to continue to reduce the drops conditional level to above 13.5 over here.
The American 10 on our year, they copy the far clear. American 2, you're not up to far clear, we're ready. American 2, they're not cleared to the Atlanta airport. And JAG 6, the departure crew that has filed. Maintain 5,000. Flight level 36010, minutes after departure. Departure frequency 134.85, squawk 1323. Hey, okay, Jack, your 9, squawk 1-3. American 2-0-9, read back, correct. Back runway 17 right for departure. Dolphin, the information alpha. Correct.
Sir, do you have a bit of a hydraulic issue? You're just going to hold our hotel for Juliet for a minute.
Estimated, we should be able to land. Thank you.
That's great. Perfect. We have everything we need over here. Let's check. Work here. Okay, so actually, I'm curious to know if the weather radar works on that.
TBM 320 Tango Bravo, being my space to the west, Houston Center is closed. Frequency change approved.
Frequency change approved,
0 Tango Bravo, have a nice night.
Stop 340, weather radar.
Delta 1684, line wind 0908, around blue line.
Delta 1684, Orlando 10908, runway 18 right, clear line.
What do we have to do for the weather? So it says TTG, so time to go. Select a nav. Got that. TTG 13.9, that's good.
For some reason our node wheel does not want to turn this evening. So we'll start troubleshooting with the earth and continue on for the 2 a.m.
Okay. So so ET just about does it. ET, that's elapsed time, huh? And
American 209, runway 17 right, taxi via Golf Hotel 1.
I will check that. One last time and set. I want to check the weather radar right now. So, DCP, VOR to and from, of course, the yellow text. So
Delta 1684, welcome for landing. You can kind of see the Yankee, Charlie, Echo, cross runway 18. Hopefully comes out from my airplane tonight. I got no idea what's going on with my airplane. It's good turn. I'm just gonna go for tank and shut down here and I'll try and troubleshoot. We'll see that next time. Good night. See that next time. Good night. Hopefully turns from the same rounder.
Alright, let's see. The tile is changing basically, so
drops and is that now? Southwest 2632, on check. Southwest 2632, on check. I get a 1969 level 3, so yeah. Yeah, 1959 Jack.
So we got everything what we need here.
with 511, thanks. American 209, turn right heading 205, Orlando 10908, runway 7 right, third for takeoff. 205 on departure, runway 17 right, takeoff.
Okay, let's talk about this number of aircraft right here. So I'm reading about
the American 209, correction, 220 for departure.
So on the blog of X Aviation. So basically, it's just like it's made by a group of real world sub 340 pilots. So it has been developed to actually satisfy everyone that actually wants to get an aircraft on their professional level aircraft on X plane. And I feel like it's actually one of the best, we know the 737-200, it's pretty full immersive, but the sub 340 for the turboprops, I think is the only, probably best turboprop available. Most probably, it's like a CRJ-200, it's very full immersive, created everything in the there are no default X-Plane instruments or logic at play here. We're proud of this achievement. So the GPS, but that's something. So in real life, except there is actually the FMC right here. Is the universal FMC is here, and then we have the weather radar. I think most probably the weather radar is right here. That's the GPS.
Jacksonville Center, Rouge 1803 with you, flight level 350. Rouge 1803,
everything else is just as the real sub 340. I'm studying the actual sub 340 manuals from an airline, and they are actually pretty good.
American 209 radar contact, turn right 80, call me 10-8000. American 209, your audio is extremely low.
Okay, so with checking according to a real world sub operation engine governor.
Greening National Center right now, that's the tree, follow tree zone, sure, checking in.
Wow, that was
great. United 353 Jack Center.
Yeah, achieved the issue we thought may be possible, bugs only to realize the simulation is doing exactly as it should according to the real world sub operations engine governing. And then, what else do we have? So I'm bringing, actually, there's pretty big section of good positive things about the South 340 here from Les. It's great. It's a 340A version, so 340 Alpha version. The thing most of the airlines now have the 340 Bravo that has better efficiency and can fly a little bit longer, I think. And I think that's the one with the universal FMC. Most probably also has the callouts, that's the newer version of the sub 340. It's just amazing how they managed to recreate the aircraft almost perfectly, like. Outside and inside.
American 209, turn right, direct one.
It's pretty close to the real thing. It got pretty damn dark.
Direct one, American 209.
Southwest 2632, Drive Marker.
Southwest 2632, Jackson are cleared to the Baltimore Airport. McCoy 2 departure, then as filed. Maintain your 5 pounds and expect flight level 370-10 as type of departure. Departure frequency 134.85, plus 143.
Okay, so... yeah, it
should
be 5,000
1
VO1, VO2, they're just like...
read back for efficient start of your discretion. Expect for 917 right for departure. Advise ready to taxi.
Solid
information Bravo.
Solid line indicates...
with the numbers
2
for 1 arrive, we'll come exactly.
And the broken dotted line, broken lines indicates from, so it's pretty straightforward. Octagonal... VOR symbols, and yep. Let's see what we have. I'll check on their website and see actually on their forums if they're going to release any updates, something different.
American 209, come to me, 16,000. American 209.
Okay, so we're checking. Let me see if we have anything new on there. Facebook page, probably they might have something. This is very old, I think it was 2012, they're talking about X-Plane 10, so. Let's see, less sub 340 forum. If there's any forum here.
United 446, contact Washington Center 133.72.
Do we get the V2 of this one? We already have it. Let's see what's our position in here. So we're reaching, we actually passed the Cross City VOR. We will be flying to Seminole 11750. Let's set up that one.
Yeah, send it up to Executive 18-11 with you, 350.
Set here.
Executive 18-11 Jack, center getting
117. 11750.
American 209, I'm gonna maintain 3360.
Okay.
came now here, what's the thing, what's the deal we have going on? So it's 307.
Jeff with 511, we plan to head to the west, Houston Center is closed, frequency change approved.
You come for JetBlue 511, thank you, have a good evening.
Let's see what speed we're flying. We're actually flying at a speed of, 258, 258 knots. That's good enough. Not bad. For that speed, so we're good. All right, so let's continue here with the sub 340. We're planning any update, we don't know yet. So the Coronado has one for P3D, so I'm kind of curious now to see what's the deal with that. Just post the view compared to the aircraft. Okay. External monitoring texture Coronado by a country mile. Well, yeah, we know that. Entirely looks photorealistic. Of course, that was what we expected from Coronado. Yep. Nevertheless, looked a bit wonky outside. It doesn't look that wonky, but internal monitoring texture, this is one a bit harder. I'll give edge to the Coronado, but only just the last cockpit isn't bad at all. System less 100%. It isn't even close. The company put system first and really shows it. Yeah. Sounds less. The Coronado simply don't sound that realistic and are based by sound phasing. Okay, flight dynamic, now found real sub, but less feels much more believable in my opinion. Yeah. Yes, we all know that Coronado is a very great product. Actually, I kind of love all their products. I own some of them. I own some Coronado products. The PC-12 from Coronado, and some other for P3D version 3 that I still own. I didn't make any flights out. Actually, if you check on my channel, you might be able to see some PMDG flights on that. Yeah, PMDG, right? That's something else too. But however, I don't think it's completely fair the comparison, because the planes are two completely different sims. Yes. That is true. We need to wait for X-Plane 11 port of XB-11 port of the Saab to make a true comparison. And then the group that ports Coronado's plane essentially takes the modeling and texturing from Coronado but builds everything else from the ground up. My experience when the ports are much better than their FSX P3D counterparts. One good example of P3D, I could fly the Coronado B1900 Delta with the throttle maxed all throughout the climb, only bringing them back to manage my speed. The first time I flew the X-Plane 11 version, I fried the engine. While they aren't study level, or per se, whatever that means, yeah, forgot that there's a lot of people who doesn't like the study level word, but. Am I still connected? I'm not hearing anything from Jackson. That's a good point. Yeah, the ports are great simulations. So this guy basically gave an 8 and a half out of 10 to less in Carinado 6. Final thoughts, neither are bad planes. Carinado is just a little pricey for what it is, but less is well worth the money. Yes, that is true. That is really true. I mean, the less sub 340 is probably the best, investment on X-Plane 11. Pretty sure, I mean, I do have the JAR design A330 that is super nice, I love it too. We recently got the Saab 3, the Flight Factor 7.5, and that's a super nice, good aircraft too, I love it. The CRJ200 though is another one that is nice. I don't know, between Saab 340 and CRJ, I would put them too. For the regional side, I think, I wish the CRJ 200 got a little bit more, a little bit more modeling from X-Plane 11, because I think it was basically an X-Plane 10 aircraft, and they just moved it to X-Plane 11, did a conversion, but it's not, I don't think it's fully compatible. They made it compatible, overall, if you love the Saab, get both. If you just want regional turboprop and don't like the Saab in particular, stick with the Majestic Q400. The Majestic Q400 is another good aircraft. It is. But that's not what I wanted. I want to know if they have to update. Let me see if there is any update to leave.
Yeah, it's not right now. It's for you with the truck.
Yeah, 350, 311, clear.
Yeah, 353, thanks.
Simulations, new update, let's see, September 2nd, 2018, that's pretty recent. What are they saying here? Last sub 340 update, and region version 1.5.1. of the Saab 340. Numerous bugs and variation animation fixes. Also, the end of the line for X-Plane 10 compatibility. So that means compatibility. A few notable visual changes were introduced, PBR for the glass objects. And objects are adjusted and the stair animation is fixed. So basically, X-Plane 10 is not no longer supported. So, so they're coming with I like that. So the thing they're making Tethny the airport where I it's placed in Italy where I used to. I know that quite a few times. It's a little new airport over there. Okay, cool. So I think they're developing that. I don't even know essentially. But 1.4, 1.5. I think there won't be any updates any soon. Let me see if I write 2.0. Oh, this is going to be a V2. So recently, September 2016. Do they have a leading edge simulation website that
Damage 11 with
people 340. So you see everything here. Yeah, lights. Okay, so what's that F down there? Check on the map, so we're getting close to Seminole. The Seminole VOR, and if the airport right down below here should be Tallahassee. Yeah, it's Tallahassee International. That's another Silver Wings Silver Airways hubs, not hubs, but destinations.
United 1959, contact Washington Center 133.72. Or Washington Avenue, 1962.
I'll be right back.
The 1675 leaving message to the North Atlanta Center is closed. Frequency change approved. Frequency change approved. 1675, thank you.
Here, our next waypoint should be coming up What a good time.
That's for my crap track, so it's closing in 5 minutes. Oh, okay. Alright,
I'll
be
back . Let's see, where are we on this boundary of that's the map. Okay, so that's good.
United 353, Tigers Washington Center, 133.72.
3323 now, 2-3, good night.
American 209, descend at pilot's discretion, maintain flight level 340.
One bottle for American 209.
American 20, descend at pilot's discretion, maintain flight level 340. Bridge 1803, contact Washington Center, 133.76.
Rouge 18003. Have a great night.
Okay. There's a lot of ATC here today, Carl. Basically, the East Coast, all the way to Connecticut. Wow, having some issues. Connecticut, I would call it. I'll say it. Jersey's offline, though. Okay, so basically we have New York Center, Washington on Jackson, and Miami. So basically we have all the East Coast except from Connecticut down. Then going west, we got Texas. So we got Houston, I think. I think it's Houston Center.
American 209, descend and maintain flight level 340. American 209, leave the land space to the North Atlanta Center is closed. Frequency change approved.
Okay, so we're going to
Central America, on some frequency, Jacksonville Center is closing at this time, while our current frequency is switched to intercom.
Okay, 1-2-2.8, it's set. Huntsville went offline, so Memphis went online, so 1-3-3-6-5 is not a thing anymore. Hotel Sierra Victor, Huntsville, and okay, it's actually getting better and better. 1406. Over here, should be good though, maybe not. Let's check everything over here. Let's check fuel. Okay, let's check everything looks. That should be. Kilograms of fuel on each tank. Good. They only use 30 kilograms of fuel, so we wait on that. No issues. Hey Giovanni, I think I'm pronouncing it correctly,
not sure,
so pardon me if it's Holder, I'll call you Holder, that will be easier. How's it going? So thanks for joining us, thanks for tuning in, and yeah, we're en route to Huntsville, Alabama from Florida, so we're doing a little southern trip. Actually we're going north, but we're still flying. We're pretty not far away, but we have almost, I would say, not halfway done, but we're getting there. We actually are halfway done, yes. So we should be able to land, I would say, in another hour. And yeah, weather looks great. We just had the ATC signing out from Jackson, so we're on this beautiful plane, the Saab 340. Know if you have if you get the occasion to get it, just buy it from the store on X Aviation. It's just amazing. It's probably one of the best turboprops available right now for X plane. But yeah. How's it going? Landing south when we arrive to Huntsville. So yeah, thanks for joining, thanks for tuning in, man. Let's see what we have. We'll give a look up the cabin right now. something cool. So. Then I just go over there to the panel. See if we have a call. And the thing will disappear the moment I press. I guess it does. But yeah. But I know this for sure. Oh, it's done. Okay. Science gets on is just an amazing aircraft. Les did a great job with this plane, and but it's basically perfect if you wanna start learning, like a not star actually. If you're, it's not basic for everyone. You need to know part of the systems, but yeah. There's a learning curve here. It's just pretty steep actually. It's basic is pretty easy, but if you want to use the aircraft 100% of its potential, you need to dig in and get information, manuals and other stuff. Les gives you leading edge of the simulation. Actually, give you plenty of. PDF actually on study material, I guess, about these aircraft, and it's just amazing how they went deep in their systems, and it's just so realistic. Said now 4,000 feet, whatever, 4,600. So yeah, it's turning. It's basically doing a long, like a downwind and then base. Thank you. 7. Oh, here we go. Should be under approach already. Why is he talking to... Overcast at 25,000, so it's even above us, no problem. 4406 still, 2995, and 20 degrees Celsius, dew point 18. Am I the only aircraft flying there? I should be, yes. Just trying to see where this weather system, like there's a kind of front moving west to east, but looks like it's not gonna be an issue for us right now. pretty soon I'll have to try on the try the new 737-800 with the Zebra mode with the new update, because I still didn't download the update. Hopefully I will do that soon, and then maybe do a stream with that. Shouldn't be a problem, maybe by the end of this week. Well, I'll see if I can upload it and then come on the stream it. For the Zebra 737, it's been a while, you'll fly them. Little beast. Just checking John Fly's channel, there's like the Milvitz T310R, so that sounds like good. I'm not sure about the TBM900 because I already have the PC12, so I kind of have that type of aircraft. I know the TBM900 is pretty good. I only heard good things about it, but I think I'm gonna skip that one for now. And if you guys have any suggestions, just let me know. See what we can get. If you have any requests of flights or aircraft you guys want to use, but yeah. Meanwhile, I see that in Turkey, so they opened a new Istanbul international airport. They're probably going to be in operation, fully operative by the end of this year, probably the beginning of the next. They're trying to replace Istanbul Atatürk International. So yeah, it's kind of overcrowded. I've been there a couple of times and I felt the congestion, yes, especially when you had to run between the terminals and to get the connecting flight that was super far away from where the gate was at the beginning. So I was at to run with all my luggage and I was like, this airport needs a little update. And the security scan, and we went outside at the airport, we stayed the day and then came back. We went through 3 or 4 security scans, one to get inside the airport, I think, and one to get inside the departure place before the actual passport control. And then another one at the gate. I was like surprised the amount of security. I mean, it's good, it's always nice to be safe, but if we can do it efficiently, it would be even better. But I mean, can't ask so much. Otherwise, it was a very good experience with Turkish Airlines. So pretty good. Except for the luggage that was destroyed. Both of our luggage were destroyed, so. So what I'm gonna do is see what we have for Huntsville. Okay, so it's crappy. Okay, DCU, that's going to be our... So basically from DCU we'll continue, and then we're going to get the approach for the ILS if it's... Otherwise I'll just go visual. Separated in altitude, I think he's like 34,000, and I'm like flight level 80. The first guy flying, like, it's been a while. I did a flight level 180 for that long. Let's check this guy out. And here he goes. That's the boy over there. That's 747-800 right there. G, and then it was GT I. Where is he going? This guy is going to... Sea Lacaux on Merkel Municipal. I don't think that's... But it could be Birmingham International. That's what it is, I think. Okay, so, so let's check how long till we get to Vulcan. After Vulcan, we should be able to get down though. Okay, so time to target is 10 minutes to get to Vulcan. Getting pretty close with 90% almost done, 80% done almost. What X-Men did is actually great on the night text. The night lightning is just great. I'm not sure if I have Huntsville Dawn on the that spot of the tile. I think I do have Huntsville Dawn. Well, anyways, at night, not this visible, it's much visible. Let's check fuel. So we're at 4,000 kilograms, that's good enough for what we need. trajectory of almost 11,000. Still good. So we check why there's no ATC available in the front, so we're good in there. I think I'm gonna stop flying the PC-12 very soon. I'll do maybe a flight with the 737-800 Zeebo soon, and then maybe do the PC-12. The PC-12 has been a long time to fly the PC-12, so yeah, I would love to fly the PC-12 again. Alright, so let's see where we are. So we passed. We basically passed the VOR right now. A few seconds ago, the Vulcan VOR. We are heading out to Decatur Delta Charlie uniform, and it's time to target 10 minutes. So what we're gonna do is basically see what we can do on BNAV. I'm gonna see. Should do procedures first. Select arrival. There's no arrival. Procedure. Select approach. We're gonna do for 18 left, I guess. Actually, before we do anything, we're gonna check which runway puts us closer to the gate. And now, okay, this is gate 11. Here on what gate do we have? Gate 11. It's basically there's 12, there's 14, there's 16. Where the heck is 11? Okay, those are not gates. I was reading the wrong picture. I was reading the picture wrong. Cheers. Google Airport Maps. Okay, good. Alright, so we do ILS 1-8. We can do 1-8 right. DCU perfect. Load or activate? We can do activate. We want to be at ILS 1-8 right, localizer 1-8 right, and it's will be at JASX, I think. JASX 3000. So we so we check Huntsville, the weather for Huntsville, and we able to check DCU while we get into my line 4. Set. Here. Okay, so we'll be passing 10,000 feet and the lights goes on. Down to 3,000. Okay, let's set up frequencies. So 109.3. It's already set in there. And the decision altitude is, we said, 1829. Set. We're going to be doing the holding, so we should be good. We can in fact reduce the okay, so 829 set, JSX 3700 on that side. I don't want to be below that, so that's good. Down to 3,000, and you can actually is completely ready, everything is fine here. And then Jet Tech 2500. Check for weather. Right. Okay, so I'm reaching Jet 6 now. I'm gonna check 12125 again. 12125.
Huntsville INTL Carl T. Jones FLD Information Alpha. 0 Zulu weather. Wind 170 at 14. Visibility more than 10. Sky conditions 7500, overcast, temperature 16, dew point 0. Altimeter 2995.
Sync goes off. Condition lever max, flaps go wet.
Beep. Wide slope. 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 Wide slope.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Huntsville. Runway. Let's do the check. Any lights off. Strobe light can go off. Okay. Let's do the other checklist. After the check, gas lock on, ice protection on, all the course and then go off. External lights set, HP valves are closed. Differential pressure check, zero, great. Flaps go up. Radar and transponders keep it on to a taxi. So we have whiskey. We're gonna take whiskey 4, and then we're whiskey 4. We're gonna take whiskey left, and maybe kilo. With kilo, we should get to the terminal area. Okay, flight tractor can go off. Juan Lima, and Whiskey 4 should be right high. Whiskey 4 Kilo should be right high. So this is Lima and Whiskey and Kilo. Since there is no actual gate number, we're gonna just pick up one. Let's disconnect from squat box and check for the replay. So the sub 340, less sub 340 on the replay doesn't have the sound, but overall, not a big deal. There was a little bit of wind, I don't know if you can still, it was like 14 knots when I was landing, but I think it was 14. Let's check that too. Let's see how it went. So it was a little bit of floating in the middle. So 140 feet per minute, so that's pretty good for an airplane that doesn't flare much. So let's do another view.
Yeah, it was a pretty long landing, though. It's not much afloat, though. I don't see much, too much floating in there, so let's do this view. See, no, there's no actually much floating. There's still give a look from the outside now. Over there, baby. But wow, that was pretty good, smooth landing. Let's do this view now for everyone else here. It was pretty good. Tower view, we have a tower view too, yeah. Oops. Well, it ended with a who did this? Oh well. Alright guys, so it's we're done for today. As you can see, we got a crash report. I don't know why it was running so smooth, and then I think on the replay just messed up the stuff. I'm gonna just put some information. Oh, well, I'll wait. But yeah, guys, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe, like the press the like button if you liked it, or dislike, and leave a comment below. Thanks for watching, guys. You guys have a nice day.